Welcome back, children. Today we are going to learn about letter writing and tenses. Letter writing, it's a formal letter that we have. So the format of the letter is, first you have to write the sender's address. That is the person who is going to write the letter. Okay. So you will write, if it's me, I will write XYZ and my address. Then after leaving a line, you will write the date. After that, you will write the receiver's address, that is to whom you are addressing the letter. Then comes the subject of the letter, about what you are writing. Then the salutation, that is respected sir or madam. Then comes body of the letter. In this letter, you have to be very precise, very short. Whatever you want to write, you can be very brief. Then is the conclusion, yours faithfully, yours sincerely. Then you will sign in your name and then you will write the address on the envelope. Now if you look here in this letter, there is no from or to. In case you are writing from or to, please do not put a comma. Okay, and everything, can you see the indent? It's in the left side. Everything they have started in the left side. Thank you also is here, yours faithful. Everything is in the left side. So make sure you write it very neatly and present it. For example, this letter, Miss Deepa, an NGO, writes a letter to the wholesale bookshop dealer placing order for 100 copies of medium size English Oxford dictionary. Now who is the sender? Deepa. So as they have mentioned the name, Deepa is given here. If they say you an NGO writing a letter, you have to write XYZ. You need not mention the name. Then we see that she is given the address, then she has left a line, whoever it is, and then the date is written, then the line is, she has left a line again, then the receiver's address, that is the proprietor or the owner of the bookshop, then their address, then the salutation, sir, madam, subject, order for English Oxford dictionaries. Then you can see the body of the letter. On reading the discount provided by your shop in the advertisement of yesterday's newspaper, I would like to place an order for 100 copies of medium-sized English Oxford dictionary in your shop. I need the copies within a week. So let me know the estimation for the bulk order placed as early as possible. Then we see thanking you and the closure, yours faithfully, Deepa. Then you have to write the address on the envelope. In the address on the envelope, when you are writing to, please do not put a comma. Another thing is yours, you should be in capital letter, and after that you have to put a comma. After faithfully or sincerely, you have to put a comma. So after going through this, please write and see, please work out a letter, write and see, so that it registers in your mind. Okay, now we are moving on to tenses. Tenses tells us when something happened, okay, whether it is in the past, whether it is in the present, or whether it is in the future. Past means what already has happened. Present means now. Future is in the future. Okay, after some time. So we have three simple tenses, that is past tense, present tense and future tense. Okay, in past tense, can you see the picture here? Something that has happened in between past and present. Action that is completed. Action that is completed. Okay, example, Ken walked to school. Now verb here is walk. Now for past tense, they have added an ed. So in past tense, you will have add ed. Ken walked to school. Okay, now in present tense, something that has been happening regularly, repeated action. Okay, see, from the past, it has been happening regularly. So Ken walks to school every day. So see, the verb walk, s has been added. Sometimes it is es. So it is generalization, continuous, a thing that has been happening regularly. Ken is smart, always is smart. Now for future, an action or state of being that will happen in future. Can you see where it is, the mark cross? So in the future, this thing will happen. Ken will walk to school tomorrow. Ken will walk to school tomorrow. Now we are moving on to progressive verb tenses. Progressive means continuous. Progressive is continuous. Again we see here past continuous, present continuous, future continuous. Something that is ongoing action in the past, ongoing action right now, and ongoing action that will happen in future. Okay. Now, example, I was talking to Benjamin. An action that happened for some time. Can you see the picture here, arrow? For some time in the past. See, ing verb is there. Was. Was is be form of verb. I was talking to Benjamin for some time. That is a continuous action that has occurred in the past. Benjamin was talking to me. The students were talking to Benjamin. Now, why were is given here? Because it is plural. Okay. Now, in present tense, an ongoing action is occurring right now. See, can you see the arrow here? Now, it is happening. I am talking to Benjamin. Benjamin is talking to me. The students are talking to Benjamin. Okay. Now, the future, an ongoing action that will occur in the future. Can you see the arrow? For some time in the future, an action will be continued. I will be talking to Benjamin. Benjamin will be talking to me. The students will be talking to Benjamin. Now, in past, ing, present, ing, future also, ing. So, that is continuous verb tenses. Next, we are moving on to perfect. Perfect verb tenses. Now, perfect verb tenses means a completed action that occurred before another point in time or event. That is, in past tense, if you take perfect verb tenses, when this happens is an action occurred before another event in the past. Two events are happening. So, one action occurred before another event in the past. So, when you come to perfect tenses, if it is past, you will definitely add had. H-A-D, had will come. Julie had traveled to hundreds of countries before she moved to Spain. Now, moved is also a past tense verb. Had traveled. So, two things are happening. One is happening before another event in the past. Can you see the picture here? Now, present perfect tense. An action occurred at an unspecified time in the past. Unspecified time in the past. Okay, the time is not mentioned. That is present perfect tense. Julie had traveled to hundreds of countries looking for a place to live. She was looking for a place to live and she had traveled to many countries. Now, here if you see, two things, both are in the past, one action before another event. But here, unspecified time, when she went, we do not know, but she went. In the past, she had gone and she was looking for a place. But here, it says before she moved to Spain, but here it is not specified here. So, an action occurred at an unspecified time in the past. Now, future, an action will occur before another event in the future. Now, see the picture here, after present. So, two things, Julie will have traveled to hundreds of countries before the end of the year. Now, specific time is there. An action will occur before another event in the future. Another event is going to happen. Before that, Julie will have traveled to many countries. Okay, based on this, you have exercises in your textbook. Please go through it and answer the fill in the blanks. Thank you.